The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.
Welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We're at Gosford City Bowl on the central coast of New South Wales, and you've been watching continuing coverage of the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. Today, you're watching a doubles match with Northern New South Wales and Southern New South Wales. I'll start with Northern New South Wales. Sarah, Simon, welcome to the show.
Hello. Hello, how are you?
Mate, going really, really good. So today, you guys are competing against Tristan and the other Sarah. What do you guys hope to achieve today?
Hope to close our frames and hopefully come out victories. Yeah. Victorious in the end.
Well, it is a bit of a different prospect bowling on television, Sarah. I guess I'll ask you is to get into the show and all that. I mean, what are you going to, I guess, focus on, think about?
I think I'm just going to take it one shot at a time and just...
That's excellent advice. That's all you can do. Just read and react, I guess. And Southern New South Wales, led by Sarah and Tristan. What do you guys hope to achieve out of today's match, besides the victory, of course? I mean, what are the key things you guys are focusing on?
Close frames, just to keep the scores rolling over, and good teamwork, because that'll come out on top, after all.
And Tristan, I mean, you had the first five frames today versus Simon. I guess the start of the match is going to be critical to the success of the team, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I'm just going to try to just have fun.
Yeah, mate, that's great advice. Up to you, Michael and Brenton.
Thank you very much, Dennis. Welcome to all our viewers this week to the 10 Pin Bowling Show, covering the 2011 Interbowl Junior Championships. And Tristan Foo from Southern New South Wales. He's 17 years of age, has the 203 average and a 299 high game. And a big welcome to Brenton Davey.
Thanks very much, Michael, and that shot is... we certainly didn't see anything from that like that from Tristan last week. He might have got a bit soft on the speed. A bit of a break between games, and quite easy to let the speed up. You've got to keep the speed constant, especially with the aggressive type of equipment that the bowlers are using these days.
Here's Tristan on his last attempt last week, tried to get a bit of a feel for the lane, covered the wide majority of it. But we'll see how he goes for the remainder of his five frames. Representing Northern New South Wales is Simon Pearce. You saw him last week. He is 17 years of age, also carries over the card average and has a high game of 297.
Hails from Grafton in Northern New South Wales. Looks to have a very, very solid game.
Hopefully fares a little bit better than he did last week. And that's a great start. Nice, solid pocket hit.
So great start. Have a look at this one. Five pin, absolutely shot over into the seven. Head pin comes back as a messenger, but not required.
Not required. Looking to make a statement early.
Well, if he can throw a strike here, it's an early 10-pin lead. Early lead in these type of matches. One-game matches, it's gold. It really is.
It's a one-game match, and these fellas only have half the game to do it, so they've essentially only got five frames to make an impression.
That's inside, way Ooh. Inside. I think he knew that it was important to jump out to a lead there. Might have just got a little careful on that one, because that was a few boards inside the previous shot and never really had a chance. Now needs to go back, make the spare, and that'll keep the match even.
Yeah, Tristan Foo's not really a bowler you want to give too many pins away to. So he's going to be going to do the best he can to stay clean. Ooh, taking that one.
Yeah, not exactly the most confident of spare shots. This one, you see that the six pin nearly slid in front of the 10, and that would have been a disaster given the way Tristan was throwing the ball last week. If he can recapture that sort of form, look out.
Great teamwork there behind play, Northern New South Wales. Just thumping fists. It's a sign of camaraderie in the sport of 10-pin if you're new to the game.
That's a better-looking shot like that one.
Wow. Great second effort from Tristan. Covered a lot of boards there, and look at the ball recover. Whack.
I reckon he hit the same target, but that time just a lot more ball speed, and it just projected the ball a lot further down the lane. Hit the correct break point. 10 the pit. Now, strike here. He has a 10-pin lead. See how he responds.
Oh, bit troublesome at the foul line, but doesn't matter.
Indicative, I think, of just trying to generate a bit more ball speed. He's tried to throw it. You know, he's trying to throw the ball fairly hard. And sometimes when you do that, your balance can be a little bit dodgy. But accuracy is 90% of the sport, and he was accurate.
That's it. As long as he lets go of the ball at the right place, doesn't matter.
Now, Simon Pearce, 10 pins behind, needs to find something. Better-looking shot. Ooh.
Went a little bit wider on that occasion, but the ball didn't quite check up as strong as he would have liked.
Unfortunately, it looked like that one just sort of rolled out in the last 5 to 8 feet of the lane, and as a result, hit just a little bit too soft. Left the flat 10-pin.
Second opportunity to check Simon's spare game. Hopefully a little bit more
convincing. Absolutely. Convincing,
yeah, absolutely. Well done. Picked up the 6-10 and now the 10. Stays clean. So not doing himself too much harm at this point.
Does it a little differently to the other players as he actually throws a urethane ball at his spares. I guess it gives him one extra option in his bag as a strike ball if the lanes get really dry.
Yeah, and this is a tack I prefer to take personally myself.
To each their own. Yeah, again, a little bit soft, a little bit inside target. Looks like he's just pressing a little bit at the moment, and it's showing in the fact that he's just not quite flushing it at the moment.
Yeah, doing his best to get inside the pocket, and that sometimes is more of a hindrance than a help. It's so important in this sport just to be able to freewheel through your shot and throw it confidently. Have a bit of trust in your game.
Yeah, well, that's more a matter, I think, of actually trying to flush it in the pocket rather than just freewheeling through a target and through a break point.
Solid spare takes away the 3-pin. Stays clean.
Tristan Foo now with a big opportunity to extend the lead even further.
Oh, no. Great shot.
A little too much angle of entry into the pocket here. Comes in from way out. That ball finished on top of the nine pin. That was just big, big angle of entry. That had no hope of getting the eight.
That was in from downtown. The ball's whizzed past the eight, left it behind.
That's the thing these days with the way some of these guys throw the ball, and you'd probably be aware of that yourself, Michael, given that you throw, you know, a reasonable amount of hook, that it looks spectacular. And when it's carrying, it looks really, really good, but it can punish you a little bit.
Absolutely. When the lane conditioner moves around a bit and the lanes break down, open up a little, that angle of entry in the pocket can sometimes kill you.
A little bit more ball speed, and it just cut down the angle of entry just enough. You have a look at this shot compared to the previous one. Ball took out the 5 and the 8 pin just the way it's supposed to.
But that's impressive from Tristan as we have a look at Simon's effort.
That one rolled out big time on him.
Big roll out there. So you can have a look at that, viewers. He's thrown the ball nicely there, but as it gets to the back end, it's used up way too much energy on the way down.
Yeah, when we say roll out, means the ball's actually in the back end of the lane rolling straight. And honestly, I think he needed to be using a different bowling ball. First shot looked really good, but since then, his reaction hasn't been good. But you live and die by the decisions you make in a one-game match like this.
Yes, and staying clean is Simon Pearce. So both boys doing a good job. And here's Dennis with the boys now.
I'm here with Tristan and Simon halfway through the match. How do you guys feel it's progressing? How do you feel?
I feel great after the fifth frame.
Mate, you're throwing the ball really, really well. You got to be pleased with that.
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about this game.
Excellent, mate. Simon, five frames in, how do you read the match?
That's all right, nice and pretty close. Just tried to find something out there. It was a bit hard, but kept it clean, so hopefully Sarah can bring it home.
And it's the girls half the game now, so you have the Sarah versus Sarah, so it's kind of difficult for you because you have a teammate in one and a girlfriend in the other.
Yeah, but I always want to win.
Excellent.
Joining me today for our short segment is Sharon Rigney Nee McLeish. Hi, Sharon.
Hello, how are you going?
I'm doing great. Sharon, you've been around almost as long as me.
Yes.
You've been a bowler. You've gone through the whole ranks. Tell us a little bit about your bowling history.
Okay, I started bowling when I was 13, which is quite late in your career to bowl. Was told I'd never make a bowler, and I went through President Shield right through to making the Australian team. And now I'm in a management role with my team from Northern. So.
Okay, so you've gone through the whole process of being a player, a President Shield player, and a successful President Shield player in winning teams, going on to then bowling State Rockway, yes, which is the state adult team, and being successful there.
Yes, yes. We won quite a few years, actually.
Okay, you've also represented Australia how many times?
About eight, I think it is, yeah.
That's youth as well as adult?
Yes, youth and adult.
Yeah. Okay, for how many medals?
I've got about 8 gold medals and about 10 silver and about 10 bronze as well.
Okay, and now you've got children who are bowling.
Yes, I do.
And are they going to follow in mum's footsteps?
I hope so, yes. I'm going to give them all the opportunity I can that I was given by my parents and just continue it on with them. If they want to bowl, I've got to stick with it.
And I'm glad to see your mum and dad still here, yes, still following bowling, even though you're old enough to go on your own now.
That's right, yeah. They just love watching their grandchildren, giving them the opportunity as well as what they gave me, so it's really good.
You think that's one of the big advantages of the game, is the fact that all ages can participate, be involved and enjoy?
Yes, it is. It's a big, big, big part of being in this team and having the support by whatever age you are, you can come in and do this sport.
And now it's interesting that you say, you know, at 13 you're considered old. By these standards or those standards?
By those standards, I think. Like my son's 9 and he started quite young and he bowled his best game the other day, 275 at 9. So that opportunity I've given him is just awesome to start that young and get into the sport so quick, and yeah.
And obviously has a little bit of talent with the,
yes,
help of mum and dad.
Yeah, just a tad. He has my spirit, I think. So
that feisty spirit, you,
yes,
mean?
Yes, yes.
The I hate to lose spirit?
Very much so, yes.
Fantastic. There you go, Sharon Rigney, telling us all about what it's like to be a parent, an ex-bowler and a coach for Northern New South Wales. Join us next time on the Tenpin Bowling Show as we introduce another special guest.
Welcome back, viewers, to the second leg of the Tenpin Bowling Show this week. The fellas have left the arena, and that leaves the girls. Sarah Terry from Northern New South Wales. She's also 17 years of age, carries a 180 average at league level, and has a high game of 266.
Not an auspicious start there for Sarah. Northern New South Wales already in a little bit of a hole, and that might have just dug it a little bit deeper. Didn't like it off the hand. Looked like she just came over the top of the ball a little bit.
Yeah, Sarah didn't have the best of games last week, but let's hope that she can finish on a high. Now she's got the first frame behind her.
Takes her medicine. Takes two pins out of the split, maximises her count, and Sarah Anita McRae from Southern New South Wales, 17 years of age, average of 197, a high game of 290.
Previous to the ladies starting, the boys did do a good job. Northern New South Wales, by virtue of Simon Pearce staying clean, was only behind by 14 sticks.
And Sarah gets the big mix off the light pocket hit. See, difference in the release, she's more behind the ball than Sarah Terry was.
Oh, The head pin screaming across the side and just tapping out the seven. But by virtue of that strike, puts Southern New South Wales on a double and have now got a sizeable lead by virtue of that open frame in the six by Northern New South Wales.
Northern really need to get their skates on. Oh, very fortunate there. Very fortunate fall on this one. Have a look at the replay. Very fortunate to take the 6 and 10 pins out there. Would have been a tough spare. However, leaving just the 3 pin should not be a problem for an accomplished bowler like Sarah Anita McRae. And it isn't.
No, it takes a 3 pin away with relative ease. Southern New South Wales now sitting on 138, working on a spare. Northern New South Wales on 101 on the open frame. So 37 pins behind now. And he's hoping Sarah can start striking and start striking fast.
Needs to do that. He's got the big high backswing. Better release, much better release.
Oh, great shot. Take a lot of confidence out of that.
Just timed the rotation a lot better on that shot. Ball's driven through the pocket. 10 pins disappear into the pit. Now, this is the critical shot now. She must double up. Because failing that, they're going to require some help from Southern New South Wales if they're going to get up and win this match. Critical shot right here. Oh, it's got a, oh, just that little bit inside.
Yeah, just a tad bit inside. The ball just revved up early and checked up.
I was trying to say it's got a push. I couldn't quite get it out. Yeah,
certainly
it's
did.
Not me, it's the teeth, they're not mine. I'm breaking them in for a friend.
The 4-9 leave, coming off a high pocket hit.
Got a run at it. Oh, yeah, she had to have a go at it. At this late stage in the match, given the situation, the match had to have a go.
That was must spare, so look, done herself no harm, but done herself no good either. And at this point, the match is now for Southern New South Wales to win.
They really need a couple of opens to give Northern any kind of a chance.
Don't think Sarah Anita McRae is going to give
Mind
them that.
Mind you, this spare is not the easiest spare in the book.
No, this is no gimme. And on this particular condition, you need to really judge this one to perfection.
And when you've got a lot of ball in the middle of the lane, not a great deal outside. Can't afford to give the front pin away too much.
Played relatively direct and hooked it at it. So she's covered that one very, very nicely. And we'll be right back after this short break. And welcome back to the conclusion of this one. We're covering the Junior State Challenge from Gosford City Bowl. Sarah Anita now stepping up for her ninth frame.
She's just been a little inconsistent, thrown a couple a little wide, couple a little bit inside. It's like she's just sort of, she's just searching for a little bit of a shot there by the look of it. And she nearly left this last time she was up, has left it this time. Easy spare to miss. Not quite the way you draw it up. You prefer to hit the three and the six pins with the ball?
No, there's every way you can wrap the three pin around the front of the six and take the ten. I've done it myself on multiple occasions, but all in all, it's a spare in the book.
In a very, very, very strong position now, Southern New South Wales. Basically, not much more than a matter of staying in the building.
Sarah Terry putting down her ninth frame and has left the exact same leave, so we'll see which method she likes to take this one.
Shows to me too that the condition's breaking down a little bit. There isn't the hold in the middle of the lane that there was in earlier matches, and I think the kids need to start making some adjustments.
Taking out the hard case plastic. Throwing straight and direct.
That's the way to shoot that spare. Perfectly executed spare shot.
Taking the 3-6 out of play with the ball, and the 6 going on to knock over the 10. That's how it's done. Sarah now to close out her game. Unfortunately for Northern New South Wales, the best they can do is 177. So they will go down swinging. Southern New South Wales already in the 190s.
I'll say one thing though, when Sarah Terry develops a little more strength, you see her just to the top of the backswing here, wrist cocks a little bit. She really wants to put some hand on that ball, and when she gets a little bit stronger, manages to stay under the ball a bit longer, she's going to throw some serious heat.
Yeah, can't wait for that to happen.
Don't think she can wait either.
That one was better.
Great shot.
As you mentioned before, Brenton, the previous shot, the wrist sort of cocked out a little bit. That one there, no such problem. Stayed behind the ball the whole way through the swing, and it showed.
Yeah, it might be a matter of getting onto the weights a little bit, building up a bit of strength in the wrists and forearms. And I think she might start throwing some serious heat. Last shot of this match for Sarah Terry.
Through the beak, taking 6, but it doesn't matter. Northern New South Wales finished with a score of 173. Southern have one on the bench. Ninth frame still to fill, and after the 8th, they are currently on 173, so the game is over. Oh, good shot. Unfortunate to leave the 4-pin.
Probably the best shot that Sarah Anita McRae's thrown in this particular match. Certainly the nearest thing to a flush pocket she's thrown, and maybe a tad unlucky not to trip out the 4-pin. Again, just got solid fundamentals there. That's what I like to see. She's got solid fundamentals, strong hand position. You know, they're looking to throw some serious hand. And if the future of women's bowling in this country is to progress, we need more girls who are out there actually prepared to throw some more hand.
And again leaving the 4-pin. Southern New South Wales throw a score of 211. It's a little bit better than Northern New South Wales 173, and it's down to Dennis.
Welcome back to 10 Pin Bowling Show. I've been watching continuing coverage of the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. Southern New South Wales, you just got that game just then. Tristan, it was well bowled.
Yeah, Sarah and I both bowled pretty well for that game.
I thought you guys did too. You had a very, very solid foundation and start to the game with your first 5 frames. And Sarah, you finished it really well.
Yeah, I did it, but thanks to the setup, it was pretty good.
Setup's only good if you finish it. It's all good. Congratulations, and we'll see you in future episodes. Simon, Sarah, it's a pretty good effort. You got to be okay with that. It is a really daunting prospect bowling on television.
Yeah, it was pretty good. We just had a couple of loose shots, and that's where we lost it.
Sarah, you can see that you started getting the flow of the game in about the 8th, 9th, 10th frame, that you're really starting to get a bit more relaxed with what you're doing. It is a really different thing. And again, there's just a switch that goes on. You go, well, it's only a camera.
Yeah,
exactly. We can actually see that on television. I'm sure Brenton will mention that upstairs as he's doing the analysis. And that's the end of the 10 Pin Bowling Show for this week. Please join us again next week for the continuing coverage in the final match in the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. Thank you and good night.
The 10 Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.